I was given this letter this morning and asked to read it. So, bear with me. It's a letter from Stephen's mother. Stephen was born to me at the age of 17 at the Lady Chancellor Maternity Home in Salisbury, Rhodesia. He was the biggest baby at the time at 9 pounds and 12 ounces. He was used as a demo baby to teach the other mums how to bath their babies. He was simply gorgeous. I could not believe that this big, beautiful baby had been created in my body. He was a strong baby that survived a difficult birth. And throughout his babyhood and childhood, he was hardly ever sick. He grew into a big, tall and strong man, but had a gentle and very soft soul. Almost too soft, you could say, for his own good. You will hear from others here about his many accomplishments through having this heart of gold, so no need for me to repeat them. The community has lost a man, and I've lost the beat of my heart since I was a young teen. We loved one another very much, and my only regret is that we lived in different cities and struggled to find enough time to spend together. He loved Nisner and would come up fairly frequently to visit us and fish with my husband. And I would travel by bus to visit Stephen in Somerset West. I last saw him in 2019, when he was so excited to show me around Kroegel Bay, his diving spot in Simonstown. His pet pig, Charlotte, and his beautiful home and precious bonsai. Farewell, Stephen, James, my precious son. My body created you, and now it must let you go. We will meet again when it is my turn to walk the path that you took into an eternity, as we all shall do. I was proud to be your mother, and privileged, in fact. I still am. I am so relieved to know that your soul is free, and that you are happy at last. I will always love you until my dying breath. Your mum forever. Love, Judy. I've known Stephen for close to 6 years. We were colleagues. We spent great times together. We spent difficult times together. And I want to leave you with this in saying that God knows and God understands what we can and what we cannot, and sometimes also what we will not. I miss Stephen dearly.
See you.